Hello friends, welcome to GCA. I hope you all are doing good. So today's video is again regarding the regimental knowledge series, and this is going to be my fifth video in the regimental series. And before that, I have already made four videos. The first is on mechanized infantry, armored corps, artillery and corps of EME. And if you have not watched these videos, the link is available in the I button. And last month I conducted a poll where 44% of the aspirants, they voted for detailed video on infantry. Although I will make detailed video on every armored service step by step, but on the basis of polling result, I am taking it as preference. And from last 2 months, many aspirants, they are requesting me to make detailed video on infantry, because infantry being the biggest arm of the army, and it is also one of the favorite arm of many aspirants. So finally, I am ready with the detailed video on infantry, and this video is going to be longer as compared to the previous videos, because it is the largest component of the Indian Army, and thereby it will take more time to explain as compared to the previous videos. So in this video, we are going to cover up what is infantry, the role of infantry, structure of infantry, regiments of infantry, then the achievements of infantry, and finally the major important facts about infantry and the modernization of infantry. So again, without wasting any time, let us start. So let us first understand what is infantry. So infantry means the soldiers on the foot that fights hand-to-hand combat with the enemy by using the small arms, for example by using rifles, machine guns, grenade launchers, mortars and rocket launchers. Unlike the armored corps, which uses tanks, and artillery, which uses heavy guns, the infantry deals in hand-to-hand combat with the enemy. So this is the meaning of infantry. Now let us see the role of infantry. So infantry play a major role in changing the outcome of war, and during the wartime it has two major roles. That is, first is during the offensive operations, which is also called as the attack operations. For example, when our army is going to attack the enemy, so it closely fight hand-to-hand combat with the enemy and then destroy the enemy. Then second role is during the defensive operations. For example, during the case of war, as you all are aware that there are offensive and defensive operations also. For example, at the one side of the border, we are going to attack the enemy. Then on the other side of the border, the enemy is going to attack us. That is, there is going to be a counter attack by the enemy. So during the counter attack, they hold ground. That is, they prevent enemy from entering our territory. So this is the role of infantry during the wartime. Now during the peace time also, infantry play a major role. For example, they practice for war, they conduct number of exercises to prepare for war. So infantry is active all the time, whether it is in peace area or whether it is in field area. Now let us understand why infantry is the most important arm during the wartime for any army in the world. So first is, artillery cannot shell a determined enemy out of position, and nor they can stop an enemy attack. For example, we all are aware that the role of the artillery is to provide covering fire, but if the enemy is determined, they cannot pull out the enemy from its position. Similarly, on the other side, the armored corps, they cannot destroy in detail, or they can nor hold ground, and its action is limited by anti-tank guns and mines. The armored corps basically, although they crosses the international boundary, but still there are a lot of obstacles which are to be negotiated. And on the other side also, there are certain number of antidotes which are basically called as the anti-tank guns and mines. So thereby, infantry is the only arm which is in the offensive operation can operate and get at the enemy anywhere, and in the defensive operation they can stop the enemy by means of its firepower. That is, by using the guns like medium machine gun, light machine gun. So therefore, the majority of the outcome of war depends upon infantry. And infantry is also known as the backbone of the army, because it is the largest component of the army and it is always at the front line. And infantrymen across the world, they are the most physically and mentally tough soldiers, because they have experience of operating in different type of terrains throughout the world, be it in the Siachen Glacier, be it in the Thar Desert, be it in the CIA operations, or be it in the northeastern parts of India. And apart from the basic regimental duties, infantry is also playing a major role in flushing out the terrorists from the Kashmir Valley, and as well as from the northeastern part of India. That is, they are actively engaged in CIA operations, and they also play a major role in United Nations peacekeeping missions. So like armored corps is known as the king of the battlefield, infantry is known as the queen of the battlefield, because infantry is the first arm to be deployed during the case of war and are the last ones to move out of war. So Indian Army celebrates Infantry Day on 27th of October every year, and on the particular regimental day, we all are aware that there is a basic reason behind this. So why Infantry celebrates its day on 27th of October? There is a reason, because on that day in 1947, the landing of the first Indian troops in Jammu and Kashmir was there to push back the Pakistani supported intruders. So that is the basic reason for celebrating the Infantry Day. Now let us understand the structure and strength of the infantry. So the infantry is made up of many regiments, and these regiments are further classified into various battalions or units, and these battalions are sequenced in particular fashion, generally in the order of their raising gear. So battalion is the main component of the infantry, and this battalion or unit, it is further divided into four companies, and we all are aware that a company consists of strength of 120 soldiers. And battalion, like we discussed, it is divided into four rifle companies, and there is one headquarter company which is headed by the commanding officer, and at a time there is a supporting company. So the infantry battalion usually has a strength of 15 to 20 officers, although the required strength is around 25 to 30 soldiers, but because of shortage of officers, one officer is doing the duty of three officers, and along with it there are around 800 other ranks and around 50 to 60 JCOs. So the battalion or the unit is headed by commanding officer, also known as the CO of the unit, and is in the rank of colonel, and sometime it is also headed by lieutenant colonel. So for example, in the SATA regiments of artillery, and this company has a strength of around 120 troops, and it is commanded by a major rank officer or sometime captain when the major is not available, and this the officer which commands the company is known as the company commander. And then company is further divided into platoons and sections. So if you want to know about the detailed structure of the army, I have already made a video. The link is available in the I button. So talking about the regimental center, every infantry regiment has different regimental center where the recruits are given basic military training, and finally which turns them to battle ready soldiers. So unlike the other arms, for example in case of Armored Corps, their regimental center is at only one place, that is at Ahmednagar. Similarly for the artillery, it is at Nasik. But this is not in the case of infantry, because we all are aware that infantry consists of different regiments, and for every regiment it has a different center. For example, for Jat regiment, the center is at Bareilly. For Sikh regiment, the center is at Ramgarh, and for Dogra regiment, the center is at Faizabad. But the basic courses are held at infantry school. So it means when the an officer or soldier is required to go courses, so he is required to undergo at infantry school, which is at Mau. So whether he is from Punjab regiment, Sikh regiment or any other infantry regiment, the basic training school for any courses, the infantry school Mau. And the role of infantry school is basically to impart training in infantry tactics, weapons and equipment. And a newly commissioned officers, that is when newly freshly pass out lieutenant, so he has to undergo YO course, which is known as the younger officer course. So for case of infantry, he go for YO course at infantry school. So every infantry regiment has their different insignia, which represents their culture, ethos and spirit of the regiment, and this basically differentiates them from the other regiments. And some of the insignias are shown in front of you. For example, for the Dogra regiment it is different, for Punjab regiment, for Sikh regiment it is different, similarly for the Gorkha rifles it is different. Now talking about the battle cry, like the regimental insignia, the battle cry is also different for every regiment, which basically makes them unique. For example, it is Jo Bole So Nihal, Sat Sri Akal for Sikh and Punjab regiment, Jat Balwan, Jai Bhagwan for Jat regiment, Jai Mahakali, Ao Gorkhali for the Gorkha regiment, etc. So now let us talk about the different regiments of the Indian Army's infantry. And in Indian Army, there are number of infantry regiments which are classified into different categories. So the first category is regional or caste regiments, where the recruits are recruited either on the basis of their region or caste. For example, for the Dogra regiment, the recruits are recruited from the area of Himachal Pradesh, Jammu and Kashmir and some districts of Punjab. And on the right hand side in blue color, the places which are written represents the regimental center of particular regiment. Then for the Gadwal rifles, the recruits are recruited from the Gadwal region of Uttarakhand. Similarly for Rajput regiment, the Rajputs are recruited एंड फॉर सिख लाई इन्फेंट्री दी मजबी सिक्स आर रिक्रूटेड एंड फॉर द सिख रेजिमेंट द सिक्स आर रिक्रूटेड एंड दिस इज बेसिकली द क्राइटेरिया फॉर द सोल्जर्स एंड इट इज नॉट फॉर द ऑफिसर्स दैट द ऑफिसर्स विल बी रिक्रूटेड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ रीजन और कास्ट. ऑफिसर्स आर पोस्टेड इन एवरी रेजिमेंट इरिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ एनी रीजन और कास्ट. सो दिस क्राइटेरिया इज ओनली फॉर द सोल्जर्स. नाउ लेट अस टॉक अबाउट द सेकेंड कैटेगरी ऑफ इन्फेंट्री रेजिमेंट्स. सो द सेकेंड कैटेगरी इज द मिक्सड रेजिमेंट्स वेयर the recruitment is not limited to one region or one particular caste. Here there is a mixed composition of soldiers from different regions and from different castes. So for example, for the Assam regiment, the recruitment is done from the Assam as well as from the other northeastern states. Similarly for Bihar, the recruitment is also done from the other states like Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh also. Then for the Punjab regiment, the recruitment is also done from the states of Himachal Pradesh, Jammu and Kashmir and even Haryana. Now let us see the third category of infantry regiments. So the third category is the specialized regiment. The first is the Brigade of Guards, second is Mechanized Infantry Regiment. So as we all are aware that the Mechanized Infantry is a composition of infantry and the mechanization. So that is, along with the infantry they uses BMPs, so they also come under infantry. Then the third is the Parachute Regiment, which is the Airborne Infantry Regiment, and here I am not going to discuss about Parachute Regiment because very soon I am going to make a detailed video on the Parachute Regiment. Now let us discuss something about Brigade of Guards. So the Brigade of Guards, it is basically the first all India mixed class, all class composition infantry regiment of the army, where the troops from all parts of the India, they serve together in various battalions of the regiment. So this basically was raised to implement, to follow the government policy of encouraging army recruitment from different classes and regions. So basically this was done to promote national integration, and for raising this regiment, different infantry battalions of different infantry regiments, they are converted into the brigade of regiments, and these are also known as the guards. So this is the all class regiment. So the fourth category is the small regiments, which include scouts unit, which include Ladakh scouts, Arunachal scout, Naga regiment, and the newly formed, also known as the youngest regiment of the army, Sikkim scouts, which was raised in 2013. Now let us discuss some major facts of the Indian infantry. So the first is, each infantry regiment consists of 20 battalions, but Gorkha regiment being the largest regiment, it consists of 39 battalions. Then the Parachute regiment of the army, which is an airborne infantry and it is also the special forces regiment of the army, it consists of only 17 battalions. Then talking about the Grenadiers regiment, the Grenadiers regiments, they have the unique and distinct honor of having the most number of Paramveer Chakras, India's highest medal for gallantry award. And then the Madras regiment, it is the oldest infantry regiment of the Indian army, which originated in 1750s. Then another important regiment is the Punjab regiment, which is the second oldest regiment, which is still in service in the army, and it is the most senior most infantry regiment, and one third of its composition was transferred to Pakistani army after independence. Then the Sikh regiment, the most decorated regiment of the Indian army, which has more number of medals as compared to any other regiments. Then Kamaun regiment, it is also one of the most decorated infantry regiment, which play a major role in the battle of Rezangla, and regiment has fought in every primary campaign of the British Indian army and the Indian army, including the two world. The Jat regiment is one of the longest serving infantry regiments of the Indian army. And Jats, who are primarily known for their skill with weapons and in combat, they have won total of 19 battle honors between 1839 to 1947. And Jat regiment has also participated in various operations which are undertaken by Indian Army and during its 200 years of existence. Then the Ladakh Scouts, it is an infantry regiment of the army which is also known as Snow Warriors or Snow Tigers. And this regiment specializes in mountain warfare, that is along the northeastern border with China and the northern border with China, that is the Ladakh area. And its primary role is to guard India's border in the high altitude area of Union Territory of Ladakh. Then the similar regiment is the Arunachal Scout, which was raised to defend India's border with China on the eastern side, that is with the Arunachal side, and it also specializes in mountain warfare. Then the newly formed regiment, Sikkim Scouts, It was raised in 2013 and it made operational in 2015, and it is the youngest regiment of the Indian Army, and it was formed along the lines of Ladakh Scouts and Arunachal Scouts, and it is similarly the recruitment is done from the mountainous border area. Now let us talk about some facts about the bravest regiment of the Indian Army. Although there are number of brave regiments of the Indian Army, but here I am restricting myself to Gorkha Regiment only, which is known as the bravest regiment. So the Gorkha Regiment was formed as a part of British Indian Army, and later after the independence it became a part of Indian Army, and it is known as the bravest because the soldiers of the regiment are known for its courage across the world, and over the years they have won different gallantry awards and number of battle honors. And currently the Gorkha regiments are classified into 7 Gorkha regiments, and out of which 6 were transferred from the British Indian Army and 1 was raised post independence. So the 7 Gorkha regiments of the Indian Army are 1 Gorkha Rifle, 3 GR, 4 GR, 5 GR, 8 GR, 9 GR and 11 Gorkha Rifle. And 11 Gorkha Rifle was raised post independence. Now let us talk about the weapons used by infantry. So the weapons used by infantry are known as the small arms. And here I am not going to discuss about every weapon, but the primarily used weapons by the infantry. So in the small arms, the first weapon is pistol, and there are 3 types of pistol used by the Indian Army: the pistol auto 9mm, then the SIG Sawyer P226, which is mainly used by the special forces, and then there is the pistol which is known as the Glock 19. So now let us talk about the SMGs used by the Indian Army. So the first is SPAS-15, which is mainly used by the special forces, including the National Security Guard. Then there is Carbine 2A1 gun. Then there is Micro Uzi, which is used by special forces and mainly in the covert operations. And there are some various variants of Uzi which are used by the special forces. Now let us talk about the rifles, that is the assault rifles used by the infantry. So in terms of assault rifles, the various rifles include Steyr AUG gun, which is also known as AUG. Then there is FN SCAR rifle and Israeli built IMI Galil gun, MA4A1 carbine gun. Although these guns are mostly used by the special forces. Now let us talk about the guns which are also used by the forces other than the special forces, that is by every infantry regiment. So the first is INSAS assault rifle. This is the main weapon of the Indian Army, and we all are aware that the INSAS is an indigenously built, and it consists of 2 rifles, the assault rifles and INSAS LMG. And the second major rifle is AK-47, which is mainly used in the CI operations. Then there is another AK variant, which is 103, and finally AK-203, which is basically the production factory has been already set up in the Amethi, which is jointly co-produced by India and Russia, and very soon we are going to have this rifle in our inventory. Then talking about the light machine guns, the first variant is the INSAS LMG, which we are using from last many years, and along with it there is MK-48 machine guns, and another gun is Israeli built Negev LMG, and recently we have signed a deal with Israel for procuring around 16,000 units of Negev LMG, and very soon we are going to have this rifle in our army. So now let us talk about the other weapons other than the rifles which are used by the infantry. Now the other weapons, that is in the category of explosives, rockets and mortars, it includes the hand grenade, which is 36 mm. Then there is multi-mode grenade Shivalik. Then there is 40 mm grenade launchers, which is Indian Army have variant of GP-25. Then there is automatic grenade launcher 30 mm. Then talking about the rocket launchers, we have 2 variants, RCL Mark II and Mark III, and then there is recoilless rifle, which is built on Jeep, which is 106 mm M40A1. Then there is RPO A Shamel and C90CR M3. Then the mortar guns which are used by the army, it include the ordnance factory built 3 variants, 51 mm, 81 mm and 120 mm, and along with it L16 81 mm mortar. So these are the weapons which are used by the infantry during the wartime. Now let us talk about the achievements of the infantry. So as we all are aware that infantry is the largest arm of the Indian Army, so thereby most number of the gallantry awards winners are from infantry. So now talking about the Paramveer Chakra, So as we all are aware that PVC is the highest wartime gallantry award, and so far 21 Paramvir Chakras have been awarded, and out of which 17 awardees are from infantry. Then from the field marshals also, we all are aware that so far there have been 2 field marshals, and both the field marshals are from infantry. Field Marshal Sam Manekshaw is from Gorkha Rifles, then Field Marshal K.M. Kariappa from Rajput Regiment. Then the Chief of Defence Staff, that is the first CDS, former General Bipin Rawat, he is also from infantry. Now talking about the Chief of Army Staff, that is the generals of the Indian Army. So far there have been 27 Chief of the Army Staff, and out of 27, 17 Chief of Army Staff are from the infantry. Our current Chief General M.M. Narwane, he is also from infantry, that is from the Sikhlai Regiment. Then General Bipin Rawat, who is our current CDS also, he is from infantry. Then before General Bipin Rawat, there was General Dalbir Singh Suhag, he is also from infantry. And before General Dalbir Singh Suhag, there was General Bikram Singh, who is also from infantry. And General V.K. Singh was also from infantry. So this basically show the strength, the achievements of the infantry. So the infantry officers, they are the most experienced officers as compared to any other arms, because they have experienced of operating in any kind of terrain. So that is why when the General Bipin Rawat was promoted as a general from Lieutenant General, there was a case, there was a Lieutenant General Praveen Bakshi from the Armored Corps. So when General Dalbir Singh Suhag was retired, so General Praveen Bakshi was the senior most in the race to become the Chief of the Army Staff. But he's from the Armored Corps, he has less experience of the Kashmir Valley and the CI operation area as compared to the General Bipin Rawat. So thereby the army considered experienced more as compared to seniority. So because of its large high experience as compared to the Lieutenant General Praveen Bakshi in the CI operation areas, so he was considered for the position of general. So now let us talk about the role of infantry in different operations over the years. So the least spectacular of all arms, but without which you can do nothing at all. So this was the comment of the legendary field marshal, and actually this is true, because infantry is always at the front line, and it has been the basic fighting arm from the very beginning. And history over the years have always shown that the victory in war is always decided by the infantry, because it is the infantrymen who basically pushes the enemy out of the bunker and makes him accept the defeat. So soon after the partition of British India into India and Pakistan, infantry played a major role. For example, it widely assisted civil authority. Then it also played a major role in maintaining law and order. Then when instrument of accession was signed between the Maharaja of Kashmir and India, so the Pakistan intruders, they started moving towards Srinagar in order to gain the territory. So it was the infantry which basically repulsed the attack of Pakistani intruders, and the officers and the soldiers of the regiments, they have never looked back, and since then they are living up to their tradition of their valor, heroism and fortitude. Then talking about the wars, in 1962 war also infantry played a major role, because the 1962 Indo-China war was fought in the mountainous terrain, and it is the only infantry that is capable of fighting in the mountainous warfare. So then in followed by 2 wars with Pakistan, in 1965 operation and 1971 war, it played a major role in defeating the Pakistan. So after 1971, then there was a number of operations. For example, the internal operations like Operation Blue Star, then the major operation, Operation Meghdoot, which was basically led by the Kumaon Regiment, which occupied the major heights of Siachen glaciers. Then the Operation Vijay, that is the 1999 Kargil conflict, which also saw the exemplary performance of the young officers, and most number of the Paramvir Chakra awardees are from the infantry in the Kargil war. Then even today they are playing a major role in every corner of the country. For example, from the northeastern part of India, and as we all are aware that there is an insurgency affected states in the northeastern part, so they are playing a major role. Similarly, like we have talked about the Operation Blue Star, they played a major role in insurgency during the 1980s in Punjab. Then they are also playing a major role in United Nations peacekeeping missions, and from last many years they have been representing the इंडियन आर्मी इन कीपिंग ऑपरेशंस इन कंट्रीज़ लाइक सोमालिया, रवांडा एंड अदर अफ्रीकन कंट्रीज़। सिमिलरली दे आर ऑल्सो असिस्टिंग सिविल अथॉरिटीज़ एंड वेरियस ऑपरेशंस लाइक ऑपरेशन सूर्या किरण, ऑपरेशन पवन, देन एवरी ऑपरेशन दे प्लेड अ मेजर रोल। सो फाइनली लेट अस टॉक अबाउट द फ्यूचर ऑफ इन्फेंट्री, दैट इज द मॉडर्नाइजेशन ऑफ प्लान ऑफ इंडियन इन्फेंट्री। सो एज वी ऑल आर अवेयर दैट वी आर इन द डायर नीड ऑफ मॉडर्नाइजिंग आर आर्म्ड फोर्सेज, because today we are facing the threat of two front war from both the sides. From the western side we are facing the threat from Pakistan, and from the eastern and the northern part we are facing threat from China. So the only option to give a deterrent to both the countries is the modernization of the armed forces. And as we all are aware that infantry being the largest arm, so therefore it is very pertinent to modernize our infantry to provide our soldiers with the latest and high-tech weapons. So the Indian Army, they have established an infantry modernization program which is known as the FINSAS, which is the futuristic infantry soldier as a system, and the infantry soldiers will be equipped with modular weapons and that will have multi functions. So despite problems, tremendous efforts are being made to modernize the infantry at rapid pace. So similarly, a lot of progress have already been made to acquire number of rifles. Like recently we have ordered light machine guns from Israel, and we have also acquired the X-95 assault rifles for the special forces. And then in October 2017 also, Army began the process to acquire around 70,000 rifles and 44,000 LMGs. And nearly rifle factory Ishapur after failed its trial because it was not matching up to the standards required by the Army. And accordingly, there is a need for assault rifles on fast track mode. And a contract has already been signed by the Ministry of Defense with the US for supplying the SIG Sawyer for procurement of 72,000 rifles. Then from this, we have also signed a joint co-production of AK-203 rifles with Russia, where the factory has been set up in Amethi. And very soon we are going to have these rifles in large number of units. And apart from weapons also, the another focus is on providing the protective equipment like lighter weight helmet and lighter weight bulletproof jackets. And Ordnance Factory Board has produced number of lightweight bulletproof jacket which will be provided to Indian Army very soon, which has a requirement of around 2 lakh items. So further, there is a major Anoop Mishra of College of Military Engineering, which is known as CME. So Major Anoop developed a bulletproof jacket which has been found to be successful, and it will be manufactured by the private sector. Now let us discuss the last portion of the video, that is who all can join infantry regiment. So this is a very good thing that anybody can be a part of infantry regiment, because it is being the largest component of the army, there are number of seats in vacant in infantry. So for joining the infantry, there are high chances through non-technical entries like NDA, CDS or NCC entry. And if you are going through this entry, then you have higher chance of getting the infantry regiments. In case of technical entries, yes, there is a chance, but it will not be easy as compared to the non-technical entries. So in order to get your regiment of choice, that is if you want to be the infantry through technical entry, then you should be higher in merit. That is in the super block, which consists of the highest ranked gentleman cadets during the training academy. Now there is another opportunity to join the infantry battalions if you are overaged, that is you are not eligible to join the regular army. So for joining the infantry battalions, if you are overaged, then you can also join the territorial army, because in territorial army there are two type of units, the departmental and non-departmental. And in departmental there are around 37 infantry battalions. So through territorial army also you have the opportunity to being a part of infantry battalions, and this is basically for those who are overaged. But if you are having your eligibility of joining the regular army, then you must give your 101% efforts to be a part of the regular army. So this is through the territorial army that one can achieve his dream of wearing the uniform and to serve the nation. And very soon I will also make a detailed video on the territorial army, because many are eager to join the territorial army and people are not aware of the basics of joining the territorial army. So I will make everything clear in that video. So friends, this is all about today's video. I hope you have gained much more today, and like always, keep supporting, keep learning, and next video will be on the core of engineer.
Until then, watch this video twice for better understanding about the infantry, and God bless you all and best of luck for your upcoming SSB.